tonight.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
We have figured out the train system in Zurich. We're like pros at this right now. The trains are super nice.
Yeah, actually.
Yeah. Yeah. We just got to the room and it's so cute. We have a little welcome. So we have some popcorn because I guess we're gonna maybe watch a movie or something later. And we have a drink voucher right here so we can come down and have a drink. How cute is that? These hotels are so nice because, you know, it's just everything exactly as you need it. It's very functional. It's like sort of no fuss around the edges, you know, it's just simplicity at its finest. So with Citizen M Hotels, it comes with this iPad and you can control everything about the room.
Cool is that? Oh my gosh. We could have like a
super moody shower.
I could be like this while you're in the shower. Maybe not green. Let's make it feel calm.
Yeah, like a purple. That's nice. Yeah, a red or something.
Yeah, purple's quite calming, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
Now they're off.
Okay, I feel like such a boomer right now. Like I feel so old. I'm like trying
what?
To. I'm like doing the.
Shut up.
I'm like, wow, you can control lights. Oh look, and the blinds. Yeah, I'm putting.
So what do you do? You just like turn them the outside down and the other ones up. I mean.
I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just pressing one. Here we go. And how are you feeling temperature wise?
Well, I think it's lovely.
Yeah. We'll just leave that the same. And we have some music, I think.
Yeah.
Radio Swiss Pop. Okay. Swiss pop music.
And this one, we're gonna do is bring both hands to the side to the feet. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And very gently, you're gonna go up to the back now. So we stretch one side, now we're gonna do the other one, yeah? Actually, we're going to do a bit of a sequence here. Go back to the center. Yeah, perfect. You see?
Yeah.
You're out. I love when you want to waste time. Hit my phone when you want to come by. Need you alone in my bed all night. All night. All night. I love when you wanna waste time. Hit my phone when you wanna come back. Need you alone in my bed all night. All night. All night. Don't tell me what you want.
So we found this pizza place right across the street from the hotel and everything's vegan. Everything's like budget friendly. I have the plant barbecue. This is the veggie garden. And very, very fresh looking. And we have very, very fresh looking. And we have our Indian pale ale as well. So it's our last morning in Zurich. Just gonna have some breakfast. It's so early right now. It's like 6:30 a.m. Still really dark outside. Really, really dark, and we are about to go and take the train to Zermatt. Okay, we're here at Zurich station. Just found the platform. There are so many platforms, and our train is on platform 31. Like the biggest train station I think I've ever been in. We've made it to Visp, I think you say Visp. Just gonna wait for the next train to Zermatt. So we've got half an hour to wait here and you can already tell how much colder it is. We're basically already in the mountains and it's just suddenly gotten so cold. So my scarf, got my hat on, this is my hoodie, satin lined beanie. Thank you.
pressure inside should be tight.
Yeah. Only when I lean forward like this.
Yeah, that's coming a little bit back.
Yeah.
So you can, when you skin, better tight is too much. Tight.
Just gonna leave our shoes in here in the little locker room, and then switch into our boots. And this part's gonna be fun because we're gonna walk. We've got to walk to the bus stop in the boots.
Should we just ask?
Well, I think that is. I think that is how you do it, because where else are we gonna leave our shoes when we're on the top of the
boots?
The only thing with the boots, they're quite hard to walk in. So, like you kind of like naturally leaning forward, and you're just like going along in the boots.
Yeah, I was supposed to actually.
What did I have on the other? It's hard to tell when.
It just go with how it felt.
Yeah.
You get a bend. Get on your knees and bend. Great. Find the balance, yeah?
Yeah. We just bought these beginner passes for today. So with me being a complete beginner, these beginner passes are going to be absolutely fine for me. And I know that Jesus is keen to get onto some more advanced slopes. But personally, I just want to make sure I'm safe. I just want to make sure I'm comfortable on the slopes. So we're just going to do this little practice. And then I'll see how I feel about more advanced slopes tomorrow. We got up.
Hey, hey.
Okay, so we just got back from our first day up at the slope. We were up there for about 2 hours because we just did like a half day beginner pass. I definitely needed the beginner pass. We actually went to like the first slope, like the blue slope, and as soon as I put the skis on, it was just like obvious, like I cannot ski at that point. Like I was like, I cannot ski. I literally don't know the first thing. I'm like Bambi. I don't even know how to stop. I don't even know how to go. Like this is going to be a disaster if I try to go down those slopes. And luckily one of the instructors noticed before I went down, and he said, do you know what, there is a learning park through this tunnel. So we went through the tunnel, went to the learning park, and when we were up there, it's just like very gentle inclinations, like if any at all. So it really just is a great place for you to learn. My word, what is going on in there? Can you hear that? He's taking a shower and it sounds like all sorts is going on in there. Like I know it's been a long day and the shower probably feels really good, but yeah, that sounds really weird. So yeah, we were up in the park and I was just literally learning the basics. I was learning like how to just stand still, literally how to stand still. Because like when you have the skis on, you can just slide and drift if you don't know how to just stand still. So I had to learn how to just stand still. I learned how to go. I learned how to turn. I learned how to turn a bit faster. I learned how to turn on a slope going fast. There were some poles and you had to like go around the poles, and it was just really great. Boosted my confidence a ton. Like I felt so, I'm getting so distracted by the noises coming out of the shower. When you look at the schools here, the ski schools, they're like 3 days long, and you're just doing that kind of what I was doing for 2 hours. People are doing that for 3 days, you know what I mean? We've just got back to the hotel and we're just gonna freshen up, and it's time for some dinner. Yeah, and then we're just gonna go back out and do all of that again tomorrow and hopefully just build on what I've learned today, step outside of my comfort zone a bit more. Just have fun with it, I guess. It's what life is all about, isn't it?
Welcome to your hotel, ladies and gentlemen. Please.
Oh, wow.
And feel so small, like when I was young. Mix it with a bit of pepper. I wanna know. I'm not on my own. Good morning, everyone. So it's another day in sunny Zermatt. And look, we just opened the curtains and you can actually see. The view from the terrace is insane. So I'm just gonna make up a coffee and we'll sit outside and just soak it all in. Starting the day with my alpine granola. It's so good. Just waiting on some eggs as well. And I'm just so excited for today. This is gonna be like our first full day skiing. We've got a lot planned, lots of challenges on the way. Yeah, just everywhere's gonna look so beautiful today. Everywhere's gonna look stunning. I feel like I'm gonna be in awe all day. So excited for that. Next, I've just arrived.
Thank you. This one, I think I've done it.
Four and three.
Yeah. Going up again for day two. Hello, hello. We're heading back down.
Yes.
Look at this. On such a clear day. Yeah. It's so beautiful.
I'm blessed today.
Wow. We're back on the beginner slope today, like the beginner practice area, because that's where I need to be. And I'm just feeling so much better today than yesterday. Like yesterday, I was a bag of nerves. I was like bambi in the eyes. And now I can actually, like, I kind of feel like I can actually ski right now, which is just crazy. So we're just gonna have a little practice around on here.
Yes, bend. Yes. Bend, yes. Bend, yes. Well done, Lana. I'm gonna die.
Woo! Cheers.
Cheers. This song right now is really speaking to us. Yes. Yes. That's how I get down there. What is it?
It is about a fall, a break, an interruption in the transmission, not in the space-time continuum.
And we are going there.
Where?
Here.
Everything is
on brand.
Yeah, everything is on brand. Everything is Matterhorn themed. They're going so fast right now. And they make it look easy. But you know for a fact. Right?
Yeah.
Look at them though, they're going so smooth, they make it look easy, but it's insane. They're like vertical. Honestly, having the best day. We refreshed a little bit, had a beer. I'm not sure if that's going to help me or hinder me, but yeah, we're going to head back down the slopes. Okay, so you see right here, I've just stopped because I'm scared. I'm gonna have to walk. Look how they just disappear off the edge. Like they just go. And like, I can't see how it is. Like, I'm just terrified right now. So that was my first full run of one of the slopes. And obviously it was much better than yesterday, but still I didn't quite nail it. So got a bit more work to do on that. Just feeling really good though, honestly. Like, I don't know, there's just something about when you achieve something that you set your mind to and you get like this rush of endorphins, they're like, yes, this sense of accomplishment. Yes, I did it. And I'm still working towards that because I did still get scared. I did stop at one point. But yeah, definitely getting better and feeling proud of myself. So yeah, I'm happy.
A few moments later.
Guys, I just ate snow from all the way up there. Oh no! I just felt like you can't even see how far that is. I was going so fast. Oh my gosh, my hands are shaking. I was going so fast and I just thought I've got no control. I'm just gonna throw myself on the ground, because then I can just stop. Turns out that doesn't really work so well when you're going so fast, and I just flew straight off the track, off the cliff. Guys, look, he's trying to go and get my ski is there, but I think that's my pole all the way up there as well, because I just right here I have one ski and one pole. I think that's his pole. Slide it down. I can't lie, that was terrifying. He's got, oh thank you, he's got it. All I saw, I think I just saw I was going off the edge, and I had no idea how far it was. I just saw that it was like there was going to be a fall, and I was like, the only thing that came out my mouth, I went, I don't know, somehow my face just went poof, my glasses are gone. I felt for sure I was going to have a broken nose or like damaged teeth or something, but somehow I've come out without a scratch. And yeah, I've just been tumbling down this mountain, and now we have to find a way back. See this, like look how far this is. This is my tracks of just falling. I don't even remember falling that far. It was such a blur. I banged my head so much. I thought I was gonna pass out or something. I feel so lucky right now. You see that? That's my glove. That's where I was just sitting. Look at this rock, this massive fat rock that I could have easily just smashed into and I didn't. Oh my God. Okay, face check. Luckily, I don't really have a scratch except this tiny little thing under my eye, but I'm deciding to call it a day, and I've gone back to the room to just have a coffee and get ready for this evening. So we're taking a walk right now. We're trying to find the restaurant that we have a booking at tonight. And just look how cute everything is. We were talking about what the residential areas of Zermatt look like, because there's obviously people that live here, and we see a lot of chalets, like a lot of ski chalets, hotels, and we're just not sure exactly where are the locals living, you know. And I think this might be it. Like, this looks very residential, and there's like a little play park for kids and stuff.
Day 2 3 4
Yeah.
So it was quite challenging, but
this was in Australia.
No.
It's the last morning, so I'm just really gonna make use of the sauna right now. It's currently heating up, and then yeah, we just have to pack and go. Which is actually really sad. I love this place so much. I definitely want to come back here next winter. Like, this hotel has been so nice. This is the sauna on. So lucky to have this in our room. Okay, we're leaving. Bye, room. Bye.